for once in my life. Gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. And as I turned up the collar bone, my favorite winter coat, the stains of the blue in my mind. I couldn't hear it in the street. There's not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them?
Come on in!
Yay! Woo!
world. And I mean, for it to do this, you have to take care of it. Like, you have to run a brush over it every day so it doesn't lose its texture, and comb its hair, if any, you know? And even change the position of its hat, if it has one, so it doesn't get sores. And maybe even put a little suntan lotion on. They're really, really sensitive, you know, some of them are to the sun. And I know they're not real, but they mean so much to us, and they can give so much to the world that, well, we treat them like they are real. And there's this one guy, Fred. He didn't treat his sock puppet right at all. He didn't take care of it, and it was missing for a week. And you can call it superstition, but we always take care of our sock puppets now, because they mean so much to us and too much to the world to let anything like that happen again.
Yeah, thanks for the ride.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Yeah, well, sorry about the pack thing. We really did think it worked.
That's alright. That's alright. What's a pack when your life has been changed?
Oh, it's so sweet. Oh, thanks.
So true.
It is true, though.
Well, bye.
Oh, bye, you guys.
Bye, guys. Bye.
Oh. May the force be with you.
It's a very important thing to us. We get along pretty well. Sometimes we argue, but we try to solve our arguments in the way of the sock puppet. That works pretty well. Sometimes it's really hard, though, because people outside just don't understand that sock puppeteering can be such a way of life. But yeah, we try to live without them. It's sometimes hard to leave the world of the sock puppet. People just don't understand. Like those hitchhiker people. Yeah, they just didn't understand their way of life. Yeah, and come to think of it, they weren't very nice either.
We can spread the sackiness in our hearts and just let it all out.
I hope they give us a chance to speak.
Yeah,
I know.
Just building up inside me.
I can't wait. I say we get going right now.
Yeah, let's get in the car, man.
My name is Ronald, and, well, sock puppeteering really changed my life. I was a little boy in a pretty poor part of New York City, going to a pretty poor New York City public school. You know, I'd get really bad ones. And then I was failing the classes there. That's even worse. And top it off, no friends, lots of enemies, many fights, much suspension. So I was spending quite a bit of time sitting by myself at home, pondering what not to do to get into less trouble. So, anyways, one day I was walking down the street. I wasn't really walking, I was kind of being chased by some bullies that have beat the crap out of me. And they chased me down this alley, and there was this old plaid sock, basically sitting there. And I decided to put it on because I'm about to die, might as well die funny. So, I put it on and I start talking to the bullies, start telling them to go away. And they start laughing so hard, I just walk out of there. The sock saved my life. They were really good students. And I got away. Anyways, now I'm a graduate student at MIT. I think I'm pursuing my career as a computer scientist with my sock. And I just want to really thank all the socks in the world for being there when we really need them. I don't see why we don't really treat these hitchhikers with some respect. They're people too. They deserve the same due process and fair trial that we do. So I think we should be judging them fairly. It's not right to assume that other people are doing things. It's happened to me before and I haven't enjoyed it. And I don't think the hitchhikers would either.
What are we gonna do now that our car is broken down?
I don't know.
This whole
really wanted to
Man, this is such a downer. Those darn hitchhikers may have dropped our spirits, but they sure didn't steal our socks.
Good job, sir.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Have any of you seen my socks?
Your socks?
It's in the car.
It's in the
probably
car.
In the car.
Please. Okay, I'm gonna go check in the car.
Well, maybe the Niffler ate it.
What a bummer. It's gonna rain.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, and then we still have to hitchhike. And, like...
We're so sad about him.
And we're gonna be so hitchhiking. Yeah. What if we have to hike?
No!
Our stuff!
Oh, my gosh, you guys! My sock is not in the car.
Oh, my God.
Did you check the whole car?
I checked the whole car.
Missing.
Oh, no.
While watching a TV program about puppeteers and their puppets and how it changed their lives, it just really inspired me to go out and find my own puppet and some other puppeteers to, people like myself to be with. So while I was traveling around the world, and while I was in Europe, I came across my sock puppet, Annabelle, and when, like, the first time I put her on my hand, I felt connected to her, and she's my best friend, and her character is an old British lady. Tribe with our group and what we're doing, what our mission to spread peace and love all over, and it's just such a wonderful thing. I think we've touched many people, and it's just so sad that things like this had to happen. My poor Annabelle. So many things been stolen. It's so sad.
I'm so bummed about this.
Okay, this suit is shy, but you told me that we should give up because this is just way pointless.
Maybe.
No! Why don't we just walk? I think we can make it.
Yeah,
we can make it to Camp David really quickly if we just follow this line.
Hold on.
never believe me. I mean, I have no part in that, but when I first joined this group, like, I was the last one to join this group, but when I did, it's like, I thought it was all about respect. It is about respect, but, like, they don't respect me. And I know I'm a dick, like, a really, like, big one, but I can't help that, okay? But really, I'm not, and I try to, like, act not like a dick around, but I can't help that. And it just really hurts my feelings, because they don't respect me. And just about the bunny ears thing, I mean, how can I help that? I mean, I see big bunny ears, and I'm just like, you know, it's like, this is thing, and they don't believe me, and now all of our food is gone, and I just can't help it, and it's just, oh!
That's where I watched many a puppet play. The puppets were always so beautiful. That's also where I realized that I shouldn't be a politician and live in a millionaire's house. That I should settle down and live in a shack in the middle of the woods and become a boatman. And my life has been satisfying ever since. Changed my life. Take my boat and my heart. What's a boat when you've changed my life?
Yeah!
Hey.
owners can't be happy, and when their owners can't be happy, they cry.
Last night, I thought I heard some really freaky voices downstairs. So today, I walked downstairs, and there was this little sock just on the couch with the remote control right next to it, and the TV is on. So I had to turn off the TV, and when I went back upstairs to, like, find a place for where I could put the sock for safety and, like, lock it up, and I found a place that I could, and I put it, and I looked downstairs, wasn't there anymore. The remote was gone, too. So what I found out was I went back upstairs in the kitchen, and, like, this really mystery. And I found sock. It was right in front of a bowl of cakes. And there was a Cheerios box right next to it, too. So what happened was I was thinking that this sock was, like, alive. So what I had to do was I tossed it out. The next day, I found it, like, right at my front door. I thought a dog had put it up there because it had, like, no gates or fences. And then what happened was just all this stuff went through my head. Like, maybe it could be alive. Maybe it had feet or something. Or maybe it could talk. And so one night, when I was going to bed, I like heard footsteps outside, so I looked outside and there's a sock right on the floor. It looked like it had moved like a lot because it had like all these wrinkles near the floor. And so what happened was I had to like toss it out again. This time in the trash and I put a lock on it, but it still came back. And these guys like they're like scaring me. They're really freaky. Don't tell anyone I told you this because then they're gonna really get freaked out and they're gonna get weird and they're gonna like suspect them and that. They might even kick me out.
I've been stuck here for so long. Nothing ever happens. We're never gonna make it to Camp David.
Come on, you guys. We gotta go. Did Harry Potter give up against Voldemort? Did Darth Vader and Luke Skywalker stop fighting? No!
It's too much.
No, it's not. We gotta keep going. Britney Spears give up against Christina Aguilera? Did the Backstreet Boys give up against NSYNC? No! We have to keep going, you guys. How about the fantasy position?
What?
Anyway, I'm going without you to deliver our message of peace.
Hey, wait! Camp David's 0.3 miles!
What? 0.3 miles?
Thank you.
And that thing where our food was stolen?
I like you.
I love you, too.
For no reason?
Well, good golly, that's preposterous.
I mean, it's like, after all this stuff happened, I mean, like, what other choices we have, you know? I mean, these socks are living in pain, and it's us that's doing it to them. We have to. I don't know. We just have to let them go. We have to let them. I mean, it's painful. I mean, they're part of us now. But I don't.
It's like when you love something, you have to let it go.
I will never forget.
I finished. I can't do this anymore. I totally can't get to Camp David. All people around the world. People need to be happy.
You know, if we want to get there by
yeah, we don't forget
to get the car, man.
What do you mean? Why won't
each other in our sock puppeting ways. We don't get along sometimes, but we try to stop.
Are you ready?
Okay, I think that's let's get Red Dog's face in the frame, just so you can tell what it is.
All right, I'll start on him. Oh, it's in the frame. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
Shiloh! Shiloh! Where's Shiloh? What's Shiloh, Greg?
I'm gonna turn over his phone. I'll move it, hold on.
Okay. Okay. One, two, three. We should do that again.
There's no hands in those socks.
I can't wait. I say we get going right now.
Yeah, let's get in the car, man.